Hi guys, welcome to my first YouTube video that I shot specifically for YouTube, Fisholover Facts. So in this channel, I would like to talk about interesting facts about fish or sustainable aquaculture, fisheries and anything related that inspired me. And yeah, I would like to share with you guys. So today I would like to talk about 5 interesting facts about tilapia. Number 1. This. There are over 100 different species of tilapia in the world, including hybrid and native species. So you might know about Oreochromis niloticus, Oreochromis mozambicus, Oreochromis aureus, but do you know that there are tilapia coffee? Yeah, tilapia coffee, which is originally located in St. Paul River in Liberia. And they are only there and they are listed as critically endangered in IUCN list. And tilapia is just a genus under the family of Cichlidae, another species named as mango tilapia, or specifically known as Ceroterodon galileus or galileus tilapia, are also called as St. Peter's tilapia. They are mostly found in North and Central Africa. And then there are other 98 different species of tilapia. Second facts. Yeah, you read that right. Tilapia actually helped Taiwanese to survive during Japanese occupation during World War II. So how did it all started? Basically, it all started when two Taiwanese soldiers managed to smuggle tilapia fries from Singapore to Taiwan. And actually, they are responsible to breed tilapia in Singapore during that time because they studied aquaculture in Japan. So they managed to retrieve around 20 fries from Singapore and bring back to Taiwan. But at the end, only 5 male and 8 females survived. And with that amount of fish, they managed to breed up to 1,500 fish within 3 months. And that is one of the great achievements for them. So they decided that, yeah, tilapia can thrive well in Taiwan. So they began to commercialize it. And one day, there's a flood. The flood that hit their farm. And after that, the fish from their farm escape and end up in other people's farm. When that happened, other people start to grow them too. So tilapia is also considered as poor man fish in Taiwan. Number 3. Yeah, they are great at converting plant to high quality protein. So tilapia is one of the sustainable fish that could be grown in tank. And being omnivorous is an advantage for them because they are not only eating plants, but they thrive on plants and microorganisms. So they could be a good candidate in aquaponic system. They have been a good candidate for aquaponic system. So what else? Besides aquaponic, tilapia also used in paddy field. Yeah, they are used in paddy field together with the paddy. So it's a great integrated system between plant and animals in one system besides being an economical for the utilization of land. So the farmers could generate more revenues instead of just planting paddy. And being omnivorous, they also could help in terms of controlling insects or pests in the paddy field. For example, paddy borers, which is a problem for paddy farmers. So instead of using insecticides, well, tilapia could also help to reduce the population of insects that might be harmful for the paddy. But there are also limitations in this system. One of it is tilapia could uproot the seedlings, the paddy seedlings. And another problem is the use of pesticides in the farm. If the farmers use pesticide in the farm, it could be harmful for the fish. Number 4. Yeah, monosex culture to produce all male fish. Basically, in tilapia, male is more desirable than female because they could outgrow female in within the same amount of time. So farmers are aware of this and they keep on producing all male tilapia. So to produce monosex culture, there are two techniques, two major techniques, either by using hormones or hybridization. Using hormone is simple, just by feeding the fries androgen hormones, and all the fries will turn into male. But this technique will leave hormone residue in the water, which could affect the environment. So most farmers will opt for hybridization, whereby Oreochromis niloticus female will be mixed with Oreochromis hornarum or Oreochromis aureus to produce all male fries, around 90-98% male fries. And the problem with this method, on the other hand, is to maintain the genetic line. So it's not easy to maintain all male production. But there are hybrid tilapia called N41, which is a progeny from both male and female Oreochromis aureus. And this hybrid is said to be outgrow Oreochromis niloticus in cool temperature in between 20 to 25 degrees Celsius. So they are more preferable in cold weather compared to warm water temperature. Number 5, one of the bad PR fish. One of the fish that constantly get bad reputation is tilapia. This is because due to many factors, from antibiotic, the use of hormones, to the claim that they were fed with chicken poop. This is because tilapia mainly cultured in China, Taiwan and Southeast Asia, Asia country. So media have been bombarded with these negative reviews about tilapia for so long. But Seafood Watch, a standardized program that helps consumers to make healthy choice, has upgraded tilapia culture in China and Taiwan from red marker to yellow marker, which indicates good alternative choice. And tilapia culture in Ecuador, which is the biggest supplier in the US, one of the biggest suppliers in the US, have been rated as green, which is the best choice. And so does domestically cultured tilapia. So this is because they are cultured in not in overcrowded environment, and they treat the waste appropriately. So that's about all 5 tilapia facts that I found interesting. Do you have any other facts that might be fascinating? Just share them in the comment section below. And feel free to share this video too and subscribe to my channel. So thank you for watching and see you next time.